Hello guys, my name is Jonathan Darko, and it's a lovely time to present you a message from the TV. Today's message is entitled Pull Down Strongholds. Use God's word and the power of His Spirit. To the Bible, Colossians chapter 3 verse 16. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. Now let's talk. There are laws of nature constantly at work, whether or not you are conscious of their existence. Gravity, for example, will work for or against you, depending on how you apply or relate to it. In the same vein, there are laws in the realm of the spirit, from where human life is controlled, and to be ignorant of their reality is to fool oneself. The Bible says, "For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty in God for pulling down strongholds." That is in 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 4. Strongholds, as described above, aren't physical barriers or walls. They are ideas in people's heads, theories that they have accepted in life that have kept them from moving in the direction of God's dream and destiny for them. Those ideas were built into their minds by satanic forces. This is the reason why some people will refuse to give offerings in church or pay tithes, though they've heard about the blessings of God for the one who does. So today's message is talking about strongholds, and saying that the word of God is mighty into the pulling down of strongholds. It can only take the word of God and the power of His Spirit to pull down such strongholds. This is why it's important for you to make a rich deposit of God's word in your spirit through the study and meditation, as you see in Colossians chapter 3 verse 16. Let the word spoken by Christ the Messiah have its hold in your heart and mind and dwell in you in all its richness, that is in the Amplified Version. This is a necessity if you must live successfully and navigate your way gloriously through life. Glory be to God. Alright, shall we open to 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 4 to 5? 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 4 to 5, it reads, "For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ." Hallelujah. This can be also open to Hebrews chapter 4 verse 12 to 13. Hebrews chapter 4 verse 12 to 13. "For the word of God is quick and powerful, and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit, and of joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart." So please repeat this after me. The word of God is my light and my life. Through the word, I live successfully and navigate through life victoriously. I'm set on a course of glory and excellence, and I make progress by the power of the Spirit. Glory to God. Alright, so this is an act for you. Memorize Colossians chapter 3 verse 16 today. Read it over and over again until you can say it to yourself without looking to your Bible. So you have to memorize Colossians chapter 3 verse 16 and read it over and over again until you can say it without looking to your Bible. Right, so I'd like to use this opportunity to thank Pastor Chris Oyakilome, Pastor Ernest Omoleme, and Augustine Ajaklo for the teaching and training. And I'd also like to thank you all for making time to listen. God richly bless you.